Hey folks, it's Greg here. We're going to do a different sort of concept, a how-to video, how to make borscht, a very economical kind of soup, very traditional in Eastern Europe. And I'm going to try to do this super fast with this voiceover format, so we'll see how it works. And hopefully I can keep up with everything that's going on in the video. So we'll start off first. Here's some basic ingredients. Everything with an asterisk besides it means it's optional. I know there's 1,000 different ways to make this, so go online, check out other recipes, but this is the basic steps. You get some sort of meat, a pound of meat, soup bone, whatever, simmer it for an hour. And then what I do is I peel the beets and I put the peels in the broth and simmer the peels for an hour. These are washed beets. This is about, you know, about a pound of beets, I guess, give or take, 3 cups of beets sort of thing. But you take all the peels, these have been washed, and you put them with that broth. It'll make it super red, super sweet. You get all that peel flavor. And then when you're done, so I've taken the meat out here, and you just strain the peels out of the broth and toss them aside. See how purple that is already? And that's normally the part you throw away. So here I am just deboning the meat. I'm setting aside the larger bones, they'll go back in, and the small little bits and pieces and stuff, I'll keep those out. But in any large bone, you're gonna put back in. But yeah, I'm just cutting up the meat and processing it here sort of thing. I'm going to add 3 cloves of garlic diced up, and I'm going to add also, I'm putting this in the pot here, I'm going to add some onions. Now you can put a couple slices of bacon in there and saute these things, brown them up a little bit. I'm just being lazy and throwing everything in one big go sort of thing, but you do gain a bit more complexity of flavor if you saute things. Here I'm adding some carrots and potatoes, about 4 potatoes. You're supposed to add about 6 carrots to this. I'm substituting in squash. I don't know, I'm probably breaking some rule, but I didn't have any carrots on hand and I just had some squash I had to use up. This is one of these things you can bend the rules, but you know, carrots are better, they're sweet, but anyway, you can bend the rules. So now you take your, there's different ways to do this, but this, and you could use a food processor for this, of course, but I'm doing this sort of like the old-fashioned way for people that don't have the facility. You just take your beets and you shred them up into the pot you're going to cook them in. And see how I got a little bit of the beet? You don't have to shred it up perfectly. Just shred it down till there's really not enough left to hold and throw it in there. And you have a couple chunks of beet. This recipe calls for half a can of tomato paste. So you throw that in here. I'm putting the larger bones back in, putting the broth back in. I think you got to add a bit of water until it, make sure all that vegetable and everything is covered. You can put celery in here too. I'm adding about 2 teaspoons of salt. This is where you'd add another teaspoon of pepper, some celery salt, bay leaves, I think 3 bay leaves. And I think that's, I have to check the ingredients again, but those are basically pepper and the basic spices. Then you're gonna put it on the oven, bring it to a boil, and let it simmer on low after it's come to a boil for about 3 hours. So here's what we look like after 3 hours. Nice, super red, that sort of thing. And just a dandy stew, goes good with some bread. A lot of people, when you serve up the borscht, you put a dollop of sour cream in the bowl with the borscht, cold sour cream. That really adds a lot of, just a nice touch. And of course you could put fresh, if you have it, put some fresh dill on there, and that's really nice as well. So some fresh bread, some fresh dill, dollop of sour cream, and you got yourself a nice meal using some really basic ingredients, saving a lot of money. It's a great dish. Hope you like it. Hope you like the recipe. Hope you like this format. Let me know what you think. And until next time, get out there, get at it. Have fun in your kitchen. Thanks for watching.